Can you walk me through what happened the day of the avalanche? You were in your tent when it happened, right?
The winds in front of an avalanche could be up over 200 miles an hour. And I'm like, no, this isn't going to hit us. This is going to go by. We picked a good spot. This is, you know, we're in a secluded, you know, we're in a safe zone. And the next thing you know, it just, we felt a slap almost. I was airborne for quite a while because I did go over through quite a few Serac, which are some big ice cliffs. And then I started feeling the actual rumble, tumble of an avalanche, maybe like you've been knocked over by a wave, you know, in the ocean before. And I was thinking to myself, my gosh, this is it. Excuse me, we've been crying a lot. So if I try to laugh and cry at the same time, it's, I said, this is it. And then I don't even really know, you know, a couple seconds, who knows what later. All of a sudden I felt it come to a stop and I immediately basically just completely started freaking out and trying to, you only have a few seconds before the snow starts getting hard like cement. What's interesting is this, the sun was not up yet. And when I finally came to a stop, I started thrashing about to try to, you know, make an air pocket or something. And I realized I'm on top of something, but I'm on top of the surface, but I'm still in the tent. And I'm thrashing about and I can't rip the tent open. And I realized, wait a minute, I'll just unzip the door. But what was really surreal is that I had been reading before and my headlamp was still on my head and was still producing light. So even though it was very dark, everything was really light. And it took me a few minutes to actually comprehend what was happening. And I realized, oh, my headlamp's on. Anyways, as soon as I got myself out, I immediately started screaming and yelling and, you know, went into a rescue mode for my friends. No sign of Remy whatsoever. I mean, he's literally disappeared. There's nothing that was anywhere near or associated with his tent visually. And Greg, even though he was sleeping right next to me, everything that we had in that tent, I found except his sleeping bag. It breaks my heart that I wasn't able to. I thought for sure he was going to be right there and we were going to be, not a cynical laugh, but going, oh my gosh, we're alive, dude. Mm-hmm. I had to call Remy's wife. I had to call Greg's father. And I also had to, you know, there's 9 other people, you know, involved in this thing too. So the scene around base camp was kind of interesting, but I kind of stayed there. And I, as far as my head is concerned, I was able to, you know, leave the mountain, I guess, well, on my own terms.